22 more Apple Vision Pro hidden features, tips, and tricks as a follow-up to the last video where I give you 25 of them. If you missed it, I'll leave a link in the description. Let's jump in and start with a follow-up to one of the Easter eggs in the environments. All right, starting with Mount Hood, I thought this was random, but it seems to be if you close all your apps, it'll start raining in that environment. And also, if you put a video over the lake, the video will reflect off of the water. You'll also get a similar reflection over the clouds when in Halakala, on top of the volcanic mountains in Maui. Next, I don't know if this one is an Easter egg, but when you're on the moon, you can look up and find the Earth in the sky. I still haven't found any Easter eggs for Joshua Tree or White Sands, so if you have, let everyone know down in the comments below, please. All right, next, did you know you can bring AR objects into Vision Pro and see them with incredible detail and clarity? A popular app for this is JigSpace, but most people don't realize you can also bring in AR objects from the web. Like for example, Apple's website. Head to just about any product page, look for the AR icon and tap on it to give it a try. You'll bring 3D versions of Apple's products into your world. Now, my friend John Prosser also shared Apple's augmented reality quick look library, which has a bunch of cool AR objects you can look at as well. By the way, you'll notice that when viewing an augmented reality object, that it'll interact with the lighting in your environment too, which is really cool. Next, this one seems to be a feature that most people are surprised by, but if you want to zoom in and zoom out on something, just grab a window or a piece of content with both hands, tap, and then pull your hands apart to zoom in or bring them closer to zoom back out. Now, despite how my friends responded to this on the Genius Bar podcast,
can I zoom into this webpage? Can I pinch?
Oh, what?
Apple! Yes!
Dude!
Yes! Beautiful!
Wait! Wow! Why is that not a demo?
To zoom is what you'd expect. Look where you want to zoom, pinch your fingers together, and pull both hands apart.
What?
Yes, Apple actually did show this one to us publicly in the guided tour. Oh, and yes, this gesture does also work with AR objects, so you can take an Apple Watch, pinch to zoom in, and make it gigantic. Next, if you're multitasking in real life while using Apple Vision Pro, you may have found that you're activating things and changing things while you're moving around. So for example, for me, I found that emptying the dishwasher and also eating while using Vision Pro, yes, I have done that, it would see me moving my hands around and take them as input. What you can do about that is go into settings and change it so that it only looks for input from one of your hands instead of both. So for me, I chose my left hand since I'm right-handed and therefore I'm gonna be using my right hand more when doing tasks. So I'd have to be more intentional about using my left hand to control the interface while I'm doing other things. All right, you know that Dinosaur Encounters app? Well, there's an extended ending with a family of small dinosaurs coming out at the end. This experience typically ends after the two big dinosaurs fight each other. But what I found is if you get up and try to interact with every dinosaur in the experience, you unlock this ending instead. I found sometimes that Vision Pro apps or windows can be just a tiny bit lopsided, but you can fix it by grabbing the placement bar and while holding it, tilt your head to adjust the alignment. When you've got the alignment you want, just let go and it'll stay at that angle that you've chosen. The Apple Vision Pro doesn't just run Vision OS apps, it'll also run legacy apps built for iPhone and iPad. But some legacy apps have touch points that are so small that it's frustrating to try to tap on them using your gaze. For these, just grab the window and bring it close to you, and you can just touch on those areas that are difficult to interact with, making navigation easier and less frustrating. All right, tapping the digital crown is one way to get to your home view, but you can also do it directly from the control center by choosing that first option that looks like a bunch of circles if you don't want to interact with the hardware for whatever reason. And double tapping the digital crown will hide everything, your apps and any environment you're in, so you can quickly get to the pass-through mode to see what's going on around you. Then you can single tap on the crown to get back to what you were doing. One small annoyance I've come across is that the control center is sometimes way too easy to bring up by accident, and it'll appear in the middle of your content, say when you're watching a show or a movie, for example. The fix for this lies in settings where you can choose how high you need to look before the control center is invoked. I moved it up about halfway, and it has eliminated this issue entirely for me. Solving another small annoyance, a lot of people assumed, myself included, that when deleting using the keyboard, that you have to constantly stare at the delete key. That makes sense since that's how everything else works in the Vision OS interface. However, that also meant that since you were staring at the delete key, you couldn't actually look at what you were deleting, unless you wanted to keep looking back and forth. Well, when you start deleting, that delete icon will appear next to your text. Then you can look there instead and keep pinching without needing to look back and forth at the actual delete key, keeping your eyes focused on the text that you're deleting instead. One other keyboard tip, when using a Bluetooth keyboard or the keyboard from your Mac, you can hold down the command key when looking at a Vision Pro app to see a list of additional commands that you can use within that app with the keyboard. I mentioned in my last video that holding down both the digital crown and the top button lets you force quit apps, and if you keep holding them down, you get the slider to shut down the Vision Pro. But there's no restart slider, but that's okay, because you can just ask Siri to restart your Vision Pro for you. Siri will confirm if that's what you actually want to do. You say yes, and done. Speaking of Siri, this is the best Siri has ever looked. You can actually grab the Siri orb, move it around in your space, and even throw it away if it does something annoying like that. Lots of people in the comments of the last video were complaining that the Vision Pro doesn't show the time. Well, you can actually get to the time, date, and battery percentage by opening up the control center. Just look up and tap on the arrow that comes up to do that. But if you want the time to be persistent within your view, then you'd need to download an app for that instead, and there are a few on the App Store that can do this. Sound recognition is available in Apple Vision Pro, similar to other Apple devices, but I find most people don't know about this feature at all, so I'm including it here. Sound recognition allows your device, Vision Pro in this case, to notify you when it hears specific sounds. So for example, I have mine set to give me a notification if it hears the doorbell or someone knocking at the door. You can also have it notify you if it hears an alarm, a dog or a cat, or even a baby crying. There are a bunch of other options in there to take advantage of so you don't miss important things when immersed in content. Here's a fun one. When setting up your persona, you don't have to use your own face. Apple Vision Pro has no clue what you look like, so if you want to take the face of a friend or family member with their approval, scan their face instead when you set up your persona. Just don't do anything devious with it afterwards. When it comes to travel mode, you've probably seen people on social media using Vision Pro on a plane, subway, or in a car, hopefully not while driving. A lot of people seem to not realize that you need to enable travel mode in order to keep your apps visible when in a moving vehicle. The important key, though, is that you need to turn on travel mode before the vehicle starts moving. That means if you want to use this on a plane, put the headset on when you board and turn on travel mode before you start taxiing for takeoff. And yes, that also means when you see people on social media walking through the streets wearing Vision Pro, pinching and grabbing at the air, they're just power walking away from their apps that they've left behind them. They're trolling you. Next, you can open multiple instances of supported apps, similar to what you can do on iPadOS. So for example, in Safari, you can open a new tab, then grab that tab and pull it out of the window. Now you can have two Safari windows side by side, or you can leave a recipe in the kitchen while leaving your work tabs in your home office. Be sure to catch my initial list of 25 Apple Vision Pro hidden features and tips right here. And of course, if you have things that you've discovered, like the hidden Easter egg in Joshua Tree or White Sands, let me know down in the comments. Keep it locked here for even more Apple Vision Pro content. Thanks for watching as always, guys. I'm Andru Edwards. I appreciate your support, and I'll catch you in the next video.